Yes.
Completion. What's with the benefit, like the real benefit of completion? Because when you talk of size, in most cases, the difference between the after compressing the same file and the original file, the difference in size is very.
The problem is that the type of data that you work with, right? You've probably not encountered situations that I encounter almost on a regular basis. I'll give you an example of a few months ago, actually, I was working on this project where I'm dealing with text, right? It's text processing, but I decided to showcase as an example. This is a text file, comma separated file, right? Original size, 161 megabytes, it's just one file. I had 16 million files, 16 million such files. Now, if one file occupies 161 megabytes, one text file occupies 161 megabytes, and you have 16 million of them. And in fact, part of what I was doing was I was moving these things in between different machines, right, over a network. So I can't, it would be counterproductive. I had access to a network, right, so money was not really an issue. But the thing is the time. Observe, original file is this, compressed file is this. This is like it's more than 50% reduction in the compression. I tried to use another example here, and we're getting ahead of ourselves, which is fine. Another example is I pulled all the resources that we're using for this course, right? Got the total size. I removed the videos, obviously, and the audio, because I was hoping I could share this with you people. So sharing gigabytes of data would be counterproductive as well, but maybe we can put them on the hub. But observe, the original size of the materials for ICT 1110, so far the ones I was using as an example, is 419 megabytes. But when compressed, it's 363 megabytes. Now, in this case, I mean, the difference is not really that much, because like it's just 13.4%, right? But still, this difference could mean spending less money. Understand?
Yes.
It would mean occupying less space on your machine. And you're not just looking at this cost alone. What if Edward shares these things with you as well, right? Maybe similar size. Right, the other courses that you're taking. What if you want to archive this information on your machine so that you keep this information next year when you're in second year, when you're in third year, when you're in fourth year? You notice that you have a lot more advantages when you compress this data than when you store it in its original form. You're saving space. You're spending less time in transmitting this data, irrespective of whether it's over the network or to a flash, right? So moving 363 megabytes of data to a flash is going to take less time than moving, 419 megabytes of data, right? Obviously, I mean, these performance gains, obviously, you notice that they make more sense when you're dealing with massive amounts of data, like this example I was giving you right now, right? This is a lot of information, and working with data in their original format just wouldn't make sense. So the question.